Our today's recipe is very special. It is apt for any occasion as it has a creaminess, a richness. It is so subtle that it's gonna melt in your mouth. Hey you magical people, welcome to Salt and Sugar Saga, and today we are making Malai Paneer. And for the Malai Paneer, we're gonna make our gravy base first, and for that I'm gonna chop all my onions and ginger. You need not to be precise in this chopping process as we're gonna make a paste later on, so you can chop them roughly. Now in a saucepan, I've taken 2 to 3 cups of water, in which I'm gonna add all my whole spices. So firstly, I have taken some green cardamom, that is choti ilaichi, some bay leaves, that is tejpatta, black cardamom, that is badi ilaichi, mace, that is javitri, and a small stick of cinnamon, that is dalchini. So we need to bring everything to a boil. Once it's bubbling, we'll add our roughly chopped ginger and onions. Now we'll add some cashews. If you don't have cashews, you can alternate them with some almonds, or you can add some almonds and cashews and add them. We need to cook or boil them until the onions are soft and mushy. Now let it cool down. I have strained the water, and once it's cooled down, we'll take all the whole spices out. Now we'll make a smooth, creamy paste of onion and cashews. We'll add some thick yogurt as well. The yogurt will give a kind of a very slight tanginess as well as a bright color. So here we go. Okay, now we have our gravy base. See how beautiful it is looking. It has bright color. Now I've taken a teaspoon of ghee. Yes, only a teaspoon of ghee. Now I've added all my onion, cashew and yogurt paste. And I don't want to waste that even a single drop. So I've added a little water and I'm going to add in the gravy. Add the salt before adding milk. If you have added milk and you have forgotten adding salt, boil the milk and the gravy and then you can add the salt. Now to adjust the consistency and to give it creamy texture, we'll add some milk, cover it and let it cook for 3 to 4 minutes. Once it's bubbling, now at this stage, if you have forgotten, you can add salt at this stage after everything comes to boil. Guys, if you haven't, do subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified for all the updates. Now my gravy is spluttering, dancing all around. So that means it's a perfect time to add our paneer. This gravy, or this recipe I should say, is really apt for any occasion as you are spending less time in kitchen and more time with your loved one, because it's really quick. You don't have to do much. You can just prepare this gravy before, a day before, keep it in the fridge and take it out, heat it up, add the paneer, and ta-da, you have your recipe ready in 10 minutes. Because I'm using frozen paneer here, the packet wala, if you have the fresh paneer, you just have to heat the gravy well and add the paneer, put the lid and that's it. You're good to go. But I'm using the frozen one. So I will cook the paneer with the gravy for at least 30 to 40 seconds. I've added little garam masala, a very little. Do not add too much of garam masala because that will spoil the color of the gravy. So our gravy is ready. Our paneer is ready. Both are good soft. Now we'll transfer it to a bowl and garnish it. Garnishing is really important because that will take this recipe to another level. So for that, first I have sprinkled some black pepper and I've heated a teaspoon of ghee with red Kashmiri chili powder, and I'm gonna drizzle it on top of that. See how gorgeous this recipe is looking. And I'm gonna add a touch of cilantro. Here you have your malai paneer, guys. Enjoy your malai paneer. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye. Keep watching Salt and Sugar Saga.